Hi, Dresser Cuties, Winnie here. Today we're going to draw Princess Red from Descendants 4. So let's get started. To draw cute Red, let's first start by drawing her eyes. So I'm going to start right here with a circle. And then we're going to come across about this wide and draw another circle. So now my two circles in, let's make them draw so cute eyes. We have two small circles inside for highlights. And a curved line at the bottom and shade in the top. And lines at the bottom. And same thing over here. So now that I have the eyes in, I'm going to come to the sides right here and spruce them up with a bunch of lashes. So right about here, draw one and two. And same thing here, nice and long. One and two. There. Then let's come above her eye, say about right here. And we're going to draw her brow. So we're just going to draw a slight angle line and then taper it down. So let's do the same thing on the other side, but right here, slight angle and then down. And thicken it up. So now that we have that, let's go ahead and give her a sweet smile. So right by here in the center, I'm just gonna draw a curve and it goes up a little bit to give her that little smirk and cap it off. You know what, maybe I'll just draw another lash right there. I think she needs another one. There, okay. So now that we have that, let's go ahead and draw her face. So we're basically going to start, let's say about right here, like where her lash is. I'm just gonna go next to her eye and we're just gonna draw a curve. So same thing here. So we're going to draw a curve coming down and I'm going to find the center. So let's say about how low I want it. So let's say about right here. I'll give myself a point. And I'm just going to bring a curve coming down to my point and same thing on this side. And connect. There, it's always the most delicate part, framing the face. Okay, so now that we have that in, let's round it off a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and bring this up. So I'm just kind of imagining an oval, so up to her brow, and then just imagining an oval for her face. So I'm gonna bring this in. I'm gonna angle a little bit as I come up. And then about right here, round it off, the angle again, and then connect. There, okay, so now we have that in. Let's come back to where her eyes are and we're going to draw her ears. So we're gonna just pop out a curve about here, drawing some details on the inside, and same thing here where her eyes are. And curve and two curves. And then now that we have that, let's go ahead and draw her hair. So I'm gonna find my center for her hair parts in the center. So say about right here, I'm just gonna draw a line and I'm gonna part it on both sides. And then right about here, we're gonna go ahead and draw a curve coming up. And let's work on this side first. So now we need to draw her the buns on her hair, on her head. So now that we have this angle right here, I'm going to go ahead and just connect it with a bunch of curves. And then we're going to go up to make this bun fuller. And then just bring it down. So your goal is just to go up at an angle and then just drop it down. So just kind of the shape we're aiming for. And then right, doesn't really matter. We're just gonna try to come in here. It's easier just to wobble the center. And we're just gonna come in here and just draw some of these shapes just to give the hair some details. But it really doesn't matter. It's just like our buns with braids and things all wrapped up in there, right? So we just wanna give it some textures while we're drawing all these things inside. And then from there, same thing over here. We're gonna bring this up. So I'm just gonna drag to about right there. Same thing. And then once again, just wobble, curve. And then same thing, you're just gonna go up. And then bring it down there. So once again, let's go ahead and just wobble across to make it a little bit easier. And I'm just going to draw these shapes in here. There, okay. Something like that. And then right about here, before I forget, I'm just going to draw some of these curves for her hairline, just to give her hair some texture. Okay, so finally we're done with that, and then we're going to draw the rest of her hair later. Let's go back and draw her body. So we're gonna find the center and say about right here. We're gonna give her a little neck. And then let's go ahead and draw her shoulder. So I'm gonna bring this down to about right here and down. And same thing here and down. And let's see. Then we're gonna kind of imagine like where her armpits would be. So let's say about right here. I'll just give myself a point. Same thing here. And I'm just going to draw a slight angle line out. Just so we know what we're working with right here. Then from there, let's start with the details. We're gonna come right about here and we're going to draw her crop jacket. So I'm gonna bring this down at an angle. Now line down. And then let's come back here. Just gonna cut it off for her shirt inside. Another detail right here. And let's see here, let's bring this down for her jacket to say about right here. I'm gonna go ahead and cut it off. And same thing here, just cut it off. And then we need to draw a collar. So about right here, we're just gonna curve and bring it in. So same thing here. Then you can pop this out if you like for some details. Just pop it out. And then let's see. Then we're going to continue. So let's come in a little bit. And same thing here. We're just gonna continue that angle. And we're going to stretch it out and down. So then about right there, I'm going to go ahead and cut it off with a curve. Going across, about right there. So this is where her little skirt is going to be. But we're just still coming out at an angle. So let's say about right here is where we're going to draw another line, and then we're going to split it. We're going to curve this and bring it in and connect. And then this side is going to split out and connect. And there's actually another layer, I almost forgot. So right here, I'm going to bring this out and connect. There. And then for some details right here, we're going to draw a belt. So she has this heart right here on her belt, and then we're going to curve all the way up, and then it gets thinner as it goes over. And I'll draw a circle here. so we know it's a belt. So hopefully you can see that, and just try and draw only the necessary details. So then we're going to find the center and we're going to draw her legs. So here and here we're going to start to part. So hopefully you don't think it's too detailed and it's too complicated. I just think these things are necessary. It's hard for me not to draw it. So then let's work on this side. I'm going to bring this down. Sometimes I worry that my drawings are just too complicated. Okay, so let's keep going. And they're kind of straight because down here, as we come down, they kind of part. So this is actually going to flare out a tiny bit. So just notice it's pretty straight and then it flares out a little bit. And then about right there, I'm going to come here and split it. There, and then her shoe is just like right in here. So we're just going to draw a curve and connect it. Then for the shoe, we're going to come right here for a tall sole. Then curve. And just to make it simple, I'm just going to go ahead draw this in here, just some laces, just to simplify it. Okay, so same thing on this side. Flare it out a tiny bit, and once again we're going to split. And in here we're going to connect it with a curve, and once again the sole and a curve and the legs all the way up there. Okay, so now that we have that, let's go ahead and draw the sleeves. So they're poofy sleeves, like 3/4. So we're going to bring this down in a little bit and then pop it out. And we're going to come about right here to finish it. And connect. And then there's a little cuff. And connect. And let's see here, and then the arms. So we want the arms to be about, the hands to be about there. So we're going to angle this down to about right there. About there. And then we're going to draw a thumb. And then round it off for her hands. And then just going to cut it off because she's wearing these gloves. And for some details right here, you bring this up a tiny bit more, and then maybe add a little crease right there. And so same thing here. And of course these sleeves are actually a little bit more detailed, but I think this is detailed enough, right? So I'm just trying my best to simplify it and connect. But we just want to make it poofy right about here. And then add a little cuff, just like the other side. And then once again, the hands. So come down, and we just wanna make sure the thumb is about the same area. So I'm just giving myself a point, and then about right there, the thumb. And wrap these fingers around. There. Now once again, cut it off. Okay, so let's see what else are. Oh, and bring this up a little bit, and then a little crease. And on her top right here, there's a bunch of hearts. So I'll just quickly draw that. There's maybe one here. Just part of it, and then there's like a lightning bolt going through it. There's another one here, part of it. And maybe one more here. There. And hopefully I've gotten everything. Oh, her hair. Oh my goodness. So then let's come back here and we're going to just draw a bunch of wobbles. So to make her hair look like it's very curly, I'm just gonna bring it down. And let's just go ahead and tuck it in to about right there. So same thing here. There, just to simplify it. And let's see if I'm missing anything. Oh, and then the details on her pants. So let's go ahead and say about right here, we're gonna break it up, and this is black, and then there's a center line coming down, and then there's a piece right here, and then there's another one here, and one more. So I'm just gonna draw this for you so you can see it, but then I'll color it later. Split it, and once again, same thing. There, and that is pretty much it for my drawing here of Princess Red from Descendants 4, The Rise of Red. I really hope I helped you draw her fun and easy today, and if I did, please make sure to give me a like and subscribe so you won't miss any new Draw So Cute videos. See you later.